So welcome to Carob's Christmas cage tour for 2015. Now, if you somehow missed her adoption story video, I will put a link to that in the description. I've had her for a few weeks now, and she has been a lot of fun. We are still working on taming, and we have quite a ways to go because I'm taking it slow, but I'll talk more about that in future videos. So she had a temporary cage before this one, and she was actually starting to get bored, so I decided to switch it up and give her some new toys for Christmas. Although I was able to keep most of the bedding from her previous theme, so that way she would have something that smells familiar and it wouldn't like completely be totally all new to her. So she adjusted very well and she had so much fun exploring, as you will see in some of these clips in the video. So we'll go ahead and get started and I'll show you everything that is in her cage. Starting over here in the front left corner, this is her food dish. It is resting on a Super Pet waffle block, which is red, just to add some color. And then on the block, there is this KT layer chew cake. This is so cute. It looks like a real piece of cake, but it's wood, so she can chew on it, and I'm pretty sure she will chew on it because she likes to chew on things. So behind that, there is this wood. I think it's supposed to be like a choo-choo train or something, but I'm just using it as like a hay manger. I put some green orchard grass in it just because it was green and it looked nice, and I wondered if she might want to nibble on it. And then inside of the train there is a red and green cupcake too. In the far left corner in the back, this is her sand pit, and it's just in a green ceramic dish. Now, I had this in her previous cage theme when I adopted her, and she is so amazing. She went and potty trained herself immediately. She always goes pee in here, and I am just so proud of her because it makes cleaning so much easier. Now, she does poop wherever she wants, but at least her droppings are dry and I can just, you know, scoop those up, but I'm so glad she pees in that dish. So in front of that is the green water bottle, which is pretty obvious. I forgot to mention that. Behind the dish, there is this Petco wooden fence. I have that standing up because sometimes she likes to try and dig at the corner, so that way there I can just sort of block it off. Plus it looks nice. And then behind that there are some oat sprays just to give it a more natural look. So in the middle of the tank, it's pretty hard to miss. I have this big ol' 12-inch silent spinner that is gigantically clunky, but it is quiet at night. I like to hear the little whoosh as she runs on it. And it's green, so it's very nice in a Christmas cage theme. So for bedding, you probably notice the red and green that is sprinkled all throughout. This is the Carefresh, which you can find at PetSmart. And then underneath that, I have some white KT Clean and Cozy. So over here, there's kind of a lot going on. I'm not sure how to explain it. So there is this wood fence that you can see over here. There's some millet and an oat spray that is sticking up to look natural. And then I have this big piece of driftwood. Now, the driftwood has some bedding that is on it just to look like snow. You can see it goes over the roof of this National Geographic wood house that is over here in the back. So I'm hoping she's going to like sleeping in this. I bought it specifically for Christmas for her. And then leading out of it, we have these little bark. They're supposed to be chews, but I think they look like stepping stones, so they're pretty cute.